deal with a lot of things, especially your affair with Hal.
Hey, hello. Listen,
Hi.
Thank you very much for stopping by over the holidays.
Sure, it was fun, except yeah. I didn't really get a chance to say goodbye to you. You were on the phone about a half an hour before I left.
Well, I got a very important call from Taylor Baldwin.
Why would Taylor Baldwin call you on the holiday?
She called to tell me that she is resigning.
What?
Are you serious?
Yeah, I am. She'll be hard to replace, but I hope that my first choice comes through.
You know what I've been meaning to ask you? What did you say to Taylor for Christmas Eve that made her change her mind about going to Tom's?
Oh, I just gave her some advice I think she took to heart.
Which was?
That I would break her legs if she went in there.
Oh, Lisa, for heaven's sakes. Do you suppose it was that, or seeing Tom and Margo walk in together, that made her leave so abruptly?
I don't know, and I really don't care. The point is that she did leave, and therefore we had a very festive time.
We sure did. Having Tom and Margo together and Franny home from Boston. Special Christmas Eve.
It was. Except, over the weekend, I mean, whenever I saw Barbara and Paul together, I just got so sad. They're trying to be so brave.
Anybody home?
We're in the den.
Tom! Darling, has there been a verdict?
Why don't you tell me what you're looking for? Maybe I can point you in the right direction.
Miriam, maybe we ought to come back after the sale starts.
Good idea.
What are we, two freaks in a sideshow? What's wrong with those people?
Honey, please, try not to let them bother you, okay?
They didn't come here to buy anything. They just came here to gawk about the trial.
Listen, you guys, how about... Why don't you guys maybe go home and I'll take care of everything here today?
Thank you very much. I appreciate it, Emily, but this is my store and I should be here, but you... Why don't we send you out to go play hockey with Andy, okay? With your new hockey skates you've got for Christmas?
Mom, I'd rather be here with you.
And I'd rather have you out doing things you'd normally do, please.
Come on. Emily? Hey, Ace. How you doing? Hey, you try out that new Wayne Gretzky hockey stick yet?
No way. That stick's too special. I found a nice place for it right on my wall at home.
Right. How you doing?
Okay. I guess there's no point in asking if
I haven't heard anything about the trial. I just stopped by to thank you and Paul for the nice times that we spent together over the holiday.
Fashions. Oh, yes, he is. Hold on, please. It's Lieutenant McCluskey.
Hey, Mac. What happened? The jury did what?
The Emmy Award winner, As the World Turns. This portion brought to you today by Rich Delicious Mountain Grown Folgers Crystals and by New Loves Deluxe with the unique Night Guard system and truly tear-proof taping.
Until she leaves.
She's left already. She's gone.
Best present Oakdale could ever possibly have asked for.
What a pair. What a...
Good.
Hey, hi. What are you going to do New Year's Eve now?
Well, Lily and I got some invitations, and we're just going to play it by ear. We're not sure.
I see. Well, listen, Lucinda and I are having an open house. We want you to all come by, and we'll celebrate a Happy New Year together or whatever.
Well, I'll try, but I got to run. Bye.
Bye,
Mama.
Bye.
These things are once.
Where
did
the birds fly
for this out? Could you move my chair for a second, please? Can I speak to you, please?
Yes.
Just tell me,
I'll
John.
See you later.
All right.
Hey.
You think you and Kim will be able to make it?
Thanks, John, but that's a holiday we usually like to spend home alone with the family.
Wow, what a great idea. Maybe we should start that tradition too, eh, darling?
Can I talk to you for a minute about this staff meeting that's coming up next week?
I have no sense of humor.
Talking about staff. Guess who has resigned?
Guess.
Mrs. Atwater.
No. Taylor.
Taylor?
Taylor Baldwin.
Yes,
I will tell you all about it.
Are you serious?
So, what are your plans for, you know, New Year's Eve? Are you,
Oh, it depends on what Mel Stevens has planned.
Depends on what Mel Stevens has planned. I didn't even know you knew Mel Stevens.
Yeah, we've been out a couple times.
Pam, I mean, maybe it's none of my business, but... I've spoken to a lot of the nurses around the hospital.
You're right,
and
you're right. It's none of your business.
Not the kind of...
Are you crazy? That's the last place on earth I'd want to go.
Why? We've been completely cleared.
Still, I don't want to go there.
Listen
really
to
don't.
Me. We have nothing to feel guilty about, and I demand, as my wife, that you come with me. I won't take no for an answer.
Apparently, the jury has asked for a meeting with Judge Emerson this morning.
What does that mean, exactly?
Well, I'm not sure. It usually indicates that they're getting close to reaching a decision.
Tom, would you venture to give us your idea of what the verdict will be?
I would never guess at anything like that, Mom. I've been a lawyer too long. But the fact that they've been out since before Christmas and haven't reached a decision could indicate something like a hung jury.
Oh, no. Poor Barbara, that would mean another trial. Mm-hmm. All right, now, come on, let's not think about that. Let's, we'll think about something happy. Like you. You handsome thing, you. I can't tell you how happy that made your mother feel when I saw you walk in with Margot on your arm Christmas Eve.
You can't? That's funny. You've told me three times already.
Have you seen her again recently?
I saw her at Lila's on Christmas Day for a couple of hours.
Wow.
But look, Mom, I don't want you blowing this all out of proportion. Margot and I are taking this real slow, okay?
All right.
Hey.
Well, hello.
I am so glad you came home for your birthday and the holidays.
Yes, me too.
So, how long are you staying?
I'm ready.
Till the jury reaches a verdict.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry, Tommy. I know how hard this is for you.
Yeah, well... No worse than the toll it's taking on the family, but enough about my problems. How you doing?
I'm making headway.
Yeah?
Paul's supposed to let me know if he wanted to go play some hockey down at Long Pond this afternoon. Didn't get back to me.
Well, honey, why don't you just call him and see what he wants to do?
Right.
I'm on my way over to Fashion's to exchange that lovely blouse you gave me for Christmas.
Oh,
for
a smaller size.
Is there anything I can do for anybody else?
Yes, I'm coming with you, Nancy, because I've got to get over to Fashion's, too. Oh, then I just happened to think, you know what a mess everything is. Everybody exchanging everything. Tom, let me know. Let me know if you hear anything.
I will, Mom.
Bye.
I will.
Bye. See you later.
Well, the verdict seems to be all anybody's talking about today. Everybody's so eager for the outcome.
Yeah.
DA included.
Barbara, listen. I mean, the fact that the jury called for a meeting with Judge Emerson, it doesn't mean anything, really. You mustn't think the worst.
Not easy to do, Hal.
Fashions. Oh, yeah, Andy. Hold on just a second. Paul, honey, it's Andy.
Yeah.
How's it going?
All right, I guess.
Listen, why don't you come over to my house, we'll have some lunch, and we'll go play some hockey on Long Pond.
I don't know, Andy. I'm not really in the mood to play hockey today.
Oh, no, go, please. I want you to, okay?
I'll be right over. See ya. Mom, you have to promise me you're gonna call me if there's any news.
I will, honey. You just have fun.
Come on, I'll walk you out.
Great.
And I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
Hey, did I ever tell you the one about the guy who walks into a store and says, hey, I want a Long Island duck?
Oh, is that the one when a guy says the duck stops here?
Yeah, you heard it, man.
Yeah. I don't know what I would have done about it without Hal these past couple of weeks. It's been great with Paul.
Yeah, well, how are you doing?
I feel numb. Barbara, if there's anything I can do to help, just let me know. No, the only one who can help me, Emily, is me, and I'm afraid it's too late for that. I've made a lot of mistakes the last couple of years, but I didn't kill James. But a lot of other testimony came out of the trial that reminded me of things that I am guilty of, and for that I have regrets. Let me take care of this. I don't think it's a very good idea if you...
I tried to tell him that.
Emily, Meg needs a dress for our New Year's Eve party. So why don't you help her pick something out? Money's no object, and you can take as much time as you'd like.
Look, I just don't think...
Emily, we're not trying to make things difficult.
Fine, Tonio. Meg, why don't we start over here?
Good morning, Barbara.
How dare you come in here?
I would have thought you'd welcome our business.
Your expenses must be enormous.
You've been looking for a long time to get back at me. Now you finally found a way to do it, didn't you, Tonio?
If you're referring to my testimony, all I did was tell the truth.
There's a lot I don't remember about that night, but the one thing I do remember is that I went back into the house after I heard the shots, not out of it.
Are you implying that I lied under oath?
I'm not implying anything, Tonio. Oh, by the way, I don't like people like you dirtying my carpet around here.
Are you throwing me out?
Damn right, Buster.
Meg, we're leaving. We can find another store. I only hope Barbara can afford to lose our business.
Barbara, what are those two doing here?
I have no idea, Lily. No idea.
Are you okay?
Yeah, fine.
Dusty sends his love. Is there any news?
Excuse me for a minute, would you please?
Hello, Emily.
Hi, Lily. Well, I was as surprised as Holden to see you up at the Snyder farm on Christmas with Dusty.
The Snyders are my family. I'm not gonna let what happened with Holden affect my relationship with them.
Right. I guess you're here to buy a New Year's Eve dress, huh? I guess the Sinner's gonna have a really big celebration.
I don't know. I'm gonna stop by Shannon's first and then head over to Meg's.
I didn't know you were friendly with Tonio and Meg.
Tonio and no, not. But Dusty seems to have made a friend with Meg. I'd be happy to go with him. See, that's why Dusty came out to the farm with me on Christmas Eve. We always like to, be there for each other.
Come on in, Greg. Thanks for coming by on such short notice.
No problem.
You said you needed some legal advice?
Yeah, take a look at this. I need to have something clarified, mainly who actually bought Montgomery Associates from Sierra.
Well, according to this contract, Tonio bought the company with an initial investment of $500,000. 75% of it was his, and 25% came from the Juro Corporation. Why?
I bought a full partnership for a quarter of a million. But the company has got to be worth more now, especially with Tonio bringing in all this new business.
Oh, I'm sure it is. I bet Tonio gave you a good deal because he was anxious to have the benefit of your expertise. Look, according to this agreement, Tonio has to pay the Juro Corporation back its initial investment, and then the two of you own the company outright at 50% each. But why all the questions?
Well, Craig Montgomery, well, let's just say that he's still alive. He comes back and he wants to buy back into his company. What is he going to have to pay?
Well, Craig alive. Well, I guess he'd have to pay the initial purchase price that Tonio paid of $500,000. Plus, he'd have to pay whatever new business has been brought in, the value of that business.
Well, I got those figures right here.
This is amazing. The company certainly has increased its value a lot. I'd say, given these figures, that Craig would have to pay something on the order of $3 million to get the company back.
Now, according to the agreement you signed when you sold the company, you'd have to pay Tonio and Holden $500,000, which was the original purchase price, to get it back. Plus any new business they brought in.
Look,
I don't know what those figures are.
I will give Craig whatever money is necessary.
Mother, that's very generous of you. Really, I appreciate it, but I think you know how Craig would feel about that.
Well, have you talked to Haniotis today?
And the American detective. There's no news, but I'm sure Craig's coming back, which is why I want his business to be in order. Now, so about that, new businesses, how do we find out what their value is?
Well,
you have got to stop promising everyone money as if you were the original Queen Midas. Well, Walsh Enterprises didn't do well in the last quarter, and your stock hasn't recovered from Black Monday. You've got to watch your cash flow.
Queen Midas, I love that. Look, darling, I took this company when it was nothing, and I made it into a huge conglomerate. I will do it again if I have to. Meanwhile, I'm going to give Craig and Sierra whatever is necessary.
So, since your monthly payments are based on quarterly reports, all I have to do is take a look at those, and we'll have some idea of what kind of money we're talking about.
The sooner the better.
Absolutely.
Jessica.
Thanks.
Look, they will let her off, won't they? I mean, this murder case, we really would like to see this come to an end.
Yes, well, if Barbara is found not guilty, the investigation will continue. There are people on the police force like Marville, Hughes, and Hal Munson who are determined to find the real killer.
You know, Marty Slovac is the meanest, the most hard-hitting player I've ever seen. So you better eat that, keep up your strength. Look, let's think positively here. Your mom is going to be found innocent, right?
I sure hope so. I just feel so helpless. It's like everything I've done, it's just not good enough.
Look, remember when you were on the witness stand and you told that story about how you and Emily went back to the house? That was a lie, wasn't it?
And you have to understand why I did it. I thought it would help my mom. I'm starting to wish now that I had just told the jerk.
Told him what?
Hey! I thought you guys were going down to Long Pond.
Yeah, we're going right now. As soon as I clean up.
Go ahead. Hey, pal. I'm very proud of you. You have been so supportive of your mom.
Well, she's always been there for me. Thanks, Aunt Kim.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, you ready?
Yeah, hold on.
Aunt Kim, promise me one thing, that if you hear any news about my mom, you'll let me know right away.
You bet I will. Now, we both, go on. Yeah. Honey,
you got it?
It's all right,
okay.
I'll take
all right,
it
thanks,
out.
Mom.
Don't worry about
all
it.
Right. See you.
Have fun.
Yeah. Hello, Mom.
Well, hi.
How are you?
Okay, how are you? How's the new studio?
Well, I love it.
Good.
It'll be the perfect place to finish my final piece of the exhibition.
Yeah, that's nice.
What's Franny?
She volunteered for the hotline.
Wish I had known she was coming home Christmas Eve. I hope Seth and I didn't make her uncomfortable.
Well, I think she's beginning to accept the fact that you and Seth are in love. I, for one, was just so glad she showed up. It made it such a special evening.
Hi, you two.
Hey, hi. How'd you go down in fashions?
I found the exact blouse in my size.
Good. Did you see Barbara?
Briefly. She's putting up a very brave front.
Mm. Oh, it just breaks my heart. If only the jury would...
Why speculate?
I found the best sweater for Andy over at Hudson.
Oh, you did?
Oh,
great. Yeah. Right. Let me see.
Sabrina, I have to know someone before I can like them.
Franny, you have every reason in the world to hate me. Why don't you say it?
I hate what's happened. I hate seeing you with Seth. But I can't honestly say that I hate you.
I used to wish for a sister. Sister close to my age. And I tried to get close to you.
But it didn't work, did it?
No, because you're so damn cold. And secretive. I thought it was just me, but then I noticed that you didn't open up with anybody, not even with Dad or with Kim, maybe with Grandma a little. Were we standing in your way, Sabrina? Did you pull back from all of us because you loved Seth and saw us as standing in your way?
No. It's difficult for me to be open with people. It always has been. When I feel a special connection with someone, as I do with Seth, it's hard for me to let go. But you haven't answered my question, Franny. Are you sorry you saved my life?
I'm sorry it was necessary.
No, I'd do the same thing again for Dad and for Kim.
I see. Well, it must be some consolation to you to know that they much rather you with a natural daughter than I.
Don't be ridiculous. Of course they don't. Mother does. I feel it, always. She'd much rather you were her natural daughter. I'm not saying she doesn't love me. She does, on some level. She tries to be fair and responsible. But she doesn't really like me. Being the same flesh and blood doesn't guarantee a natural affinity for one another.
thought I should love you because you were my half-sister. I felt the same way. And I was angry because I couldn't. So was I. Maybe we should just stop trying so hard. Yes, I think so. Let's see how it goes. Hello, Sabrina.
Funny. I was just thinking about you.
Emily, sorry we didn't see more of you over the Christmas holiday.
Well, Holden and I spent most of our time up at the Snyder farm.
How's married life?
I love it. Everything is working out just the way I planned. I know that nobody agreed with the way that we got married and what a big rush it was, but I don't know, after the years with my mother and then the relationship with James, it's pretty special to have somebody there for you no matter what.
That's the way it's supposed to be. I'm happy for you, kid.
Thank you. That means a lot to me. Now I have to go see Dr. Michaels. You want to walk with me?
Yeah, I'll walk with you. I'm going that way.
Hi, Dr. Hughes. Hi, Emily.
Hi.
Here to see Dr. Samuels?
No, I'm here to see Dr. Michaels.
Oh. Well, see you New Year's Eve, if not before.
Okay, bye-bye.
Hey, Meg, you going to class?
Oh.
Dinner. Nothing.
Listen, Meg, I hope you don't worry about all these people talking about Tony. I mean, it's just a lot of gossip. And you should hear them talking about it, me and Dusty, when we...
Pam, we're not talking about some romance. We're talking about testimony that could put a woman in prison for the rest of her life.
Meg, you're married to the man. I mean, of course you believe he's telling the truth, don't you?
Honestly, Barbara, I am so sorry. It just makes me sick to death. People making you so
upset. All right, Lisa. I've been dealing with it all day long. Look, sweetheart, I know
the jury is going to find you innocent. I know that in my heart. Hal knows it, too.
Hal's been such a good friend the last couple of weeks.
Just a friend.
Hmm? Well, when I heard about him and Margot calling off their commitment to each other, I couldn't help but think that... All I can think about is the trial, Lisa. It's just the trial.
No.
Hal? Something happened.
Yeah. The jury's reached a verdict.
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you today by Pringles Potato Chips, regular light rippled cheesems and sour cream and onion. And by April Fresh Downy, bursting with fluffy softness. We'll continue with part two of As the World Turns in just a moment. And now part two of As the World Turns.
What?
Oh, should know better than to sneak up on people.
Well, you were making so much noise slamming drawers, I don't think you'd have heard an elephant stomp in here.
Looking for some evidence, anything, anything at all, a clue or something that will help clear Barbara and... Damn it, I'm running out of time.
I think we may already have.
What?
The jury's reached a verdict.
What? What are you doing? Why aren't you at the courthouse?
Well, Judge Emerson has some important business concerning another trial. He wants to talk with Jessica and me before the jury comes in. The verdict won't be read until 4 o'clock.
You look beat, look wiped out.
I am. I've been going over and over these transcripts, all the evidence, the testimony.
Why? You can't change things now.
I know. I just want to be sure I presented a fair case, that's all.
Tom, I was there most of the time. Believe me, you did.
I know some people that might take issue with that
stuff. Well, those people don't know what it costs you emotionally, you know, to prosecute someone you knew so well.
Do you know how nice it is to talk to you like this again? I want to tell you something else. No matter what the outcome of this whole thing is, I would like it not to change what we've been...
Tom. We're going to take it one step at a time, okay?
Well, that's fine by me. I like walking slowly, as
as long as it's with you.
I'll be there when they bring in a verdict.
Well, thank you.
I was thinking about a conversation we had a few months ago. About how we weren't relating as sisters.
Yeah, I remember that.
I had almost the same conversation with Mother. And she said something that I've thought about. That you can't really like a person until you know them.
Yeah, that's true, I suppose.
I'm trying very hard to let my parents know me. And I do hope that I'll have the same opportunity with you.
Well, it may be difficult with me in Boston now, but maybe over the summer.
I look forward to it.
So, how's Seth's book coming?
He's still waiting to hear from the publisher in Chicago, but he refuses to get his hopes up.
Yeah, Sabrina, it's important that Seth believe in himself and in his talent. You can help him with that.
Oh, yes, I plan to. Actually, I'm going out to the farm right now to talk to him about starting a new novel. He's been unwilling to start a new project till he hears something positive about the first.
Yeah. Well, he's really talented. But he needs a lot of encouragement.
Hopefully the new word processor I gave him for Christmas will be some incentive once he learns to use it.
Well, I'll give my love to the Snyders, okay?
Yes, I will. See you later.
Did you and, Sabrina, have a chance to talk?
Oh, yeah.
How's it going?
Well, we have a way to go. I don't know. She seems to want to open up more, though, not just to me, but to everybody.
Well, sweetheart, I know how difficult this is for you.
I must be making some progress. I actually gave her advice about Seth.
Oh, so
dumb?
Oh, what?
Honey.
Sad, isn't
oh,
it?
Oh, no.
Hello? Sweet.
Nancy?
Hello, Lisa, yes.
I'm just calling to let you know the verdict will be read at 4 o'clock.
This afternoon?
Yes. Now, listen. Barbara wants Kim to know that under no circumstances is Paul to be there, okay?
Yes, we understand. And we will take care of it. Thanks for calling, dear. Lisa says that the verdict will be read this afternoon at 4 o'clock.
Oh, Lord.
And under no circumstances does Barbara want Paul to be there.
I see. Well, why don't I call Bob and see if he'll go out to Long Pond and make sure that Paul doesn't go down to the courthouse.
What's the matter?
Well, it just struck me that the jury's made a decision by 4 o'clock this afternoon. Well, they'll... 4 o'clock this afternoon. Barbara will know.
Come on, come on, come on. The coast is clear.
Dr. Peretti, we've got to start meeting like this.
All right. How about our bedroom? 6 o'clock. How's that sound?
6 o'clock. Synchronize your watch.
Yeah.
Sorry. I thought that Lily Dusty might be here.
Nope. Haven't seen him lately.
Oh, sorry. But actually, Lila, I wanted to talk to you because I had a meeting with Jessica Griffin about Montgomery & Associates, and I thought maybe we could talk it over.
Oh, yeah, I want to talk to you about that, but we have to get back to work. Why don't you come to dinner tonight with Bryant, okay?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
You two don't want to be alone?
Whoa, she's got me at 6 o'clock, but I figured by 7:30 she'll be through with me.
All right, well, I'd love to then. Sounds right. Great. Can I bring anything?
No, but we'll see you later.
Oh, good. Hi. I've been looking for you two.
Hi. How are you doing?
Mm. Hey, news about Craig? No, no, but I've been trying to get his business in order for him when he gets back.
Oh, that's wonderful. I haven't seen you this happy in such a long time. I just hope that...
Stop. I know he's coming home.
Sierra. Sierra. Sierra, I have unbelievable news.
What?
I got a phone call from Manuel.
Pereira?
Yes.
But wait, I thought he was dead.
Not only is he alive, he is creating a new government in Montega.
Wait, what about the Black Angel?
Angel Ibanez was assassinated. His government was overthrown.
Excuse me, what are you talking about? Who are these people?
Oh, well, these were friends of ours before the revolution, but, well, Manuel, we thought, was dead.
But he'd only gone into hiding. And now Manuel has started a new government there. Now, some of the Black Angel's men are still fighting in the hills. I'm going to the bank. I'm going to wire some money to Manuel to try and help in any way that I can. I thought you would want to know, so you...
Oh, absolutely, no. Thank you for telling me. And I'll send money as well, and please give my best to Manuel.
I will.
It's great. I mean, you don't know what it's like to have something back that you thought you'd lost. It's sort of like hearing that Craig was alive.
I don't apologize. I understand.
I don't know if you can understand without having gone through it.
Happy for you, Sierra.
Oh, thanks.
Bummer, Marty slow back in.
But this is...
Yeah, we would have beat him if you've been playing your hardest.
Yeah, I'll count with everything that's been happening.
You know, I remember we used to come down here every winter and just goof off, had a great time.
Yeah.
Everything was so simple back then.
Andy, I don't think anything was ever simple for me.
These are supposed to be the best years of our life.
But I hate to believe that.
Yeah, the pressure's really gonna start when we go back to school. We gotta think about college and what we're gonna do with our lives. You know, how am I supposed to know at 17 what I'm gonna be doing at 40? Do you have any idea?
I don't know, probably going to some sort of business or something.
I used to know that much. My dad has always wanted me to be a doctor, but 9 or 10 more years of school just does not suit me.
So tell him you don't wanna do it.
Are you kidding? If you had a father like... I'm sorry.
It's all right, don't worry about it. You know, my mom wouldn't be in this fix she's in now if it weren't for my dad. He's hurt her all those years, and now, even when he's dead, he's still hurting her.
See you guys later.
So long, guys.
Take it easy.
Nice game.
Again.
Andy?
Over here, Bob.
Bob, any news?
The jury's gonna bring in the verdict in about an hour.
I gotta get to the courtroom.
Now, Paul, your mother doesn't want you in court.
Bob, I have to.
Right
be there
now,
for
you have to do what's best for your mother. You guys want to lift back to the house before I go back to court?
No, I got my car.
Okay, I'll see you back there then.
Drive carefully. What are you gonna do?
I have to be at that courtroom with my mom. Come on, you coming?
Sure. Just warm up the car.
All right, hurry up.
I don't want to hear any more bad news about my company. I only want enthusiastic words. And just remember, I turned this company around. I've done it before, and I can do it again if needed.
Well, sometimes it's easier to build up a small corporation than it is to save a huge conglomerate.
It can't be that bad.
No, it is that bad.
Oh, I wish I had Craig with me.
Well, you don't. Nor do you have Holden or Tonio. Those two young firebrands looked after your holdings, brought in new business as well.
Well, we'll just have to find some more. We'll breathe life into them. That's what we'll do. Oh, what about that young man that poor dear Corinne, God rest her soul, was so excited about?
Yeah, well, that's another problem. Now, the Lawrence Division was one of the few to show a profit last year. Our contract with them is vital to Walsh. But Monica might decide to take her business elsewhere if you don't live up to the terms. And those terms include responsible financial management. And you know you're dangerously close to not living up to those terms. Why not? Because you haven't...
No,
Mother?
Replaced Holden.
Ah, thank heavens you come to save me from this boring soothsayer of doom.
Oh, stop.
What brings you back, darling?
Well, John's brought me over here because I have wonderful news.
How are you doing?
Craig? No, but it's almost as good. Mother, there's been a counter-revolution in Montega. A friend of mine is in charge of the government now.
Oh, I'm happy to hear that, darling.
Mother?
Huh?
Don't you see? This is a good omen. It means that things are turning around.
Oh, of course I do. I'm sorry. Of course they're turning around. What can I do to be of help?
Well, there are a lot of things you could do, but first off, my friend Manuel Pereira is in charge of the government now. He needs more money to help rebuild and stabilize the government. Now, I've already written a check.
I knew his father. Now, wait a minute, dear. You know, I wasn't very happy in Montega. They threw me out of that country. They made me give up my baby. Why would I give them money?
Mother.
Oh,
this
right.
is important
for you, darling.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, would somebody get that? I'm hugging my daughter.
Hello.
Oh,
Gwen. All right, thanks for calling. We better get over to the courthouse. The jury's reached a verdict.
I'm glad you could be there to support Barbara.
Yeah,
Let me know if something happens.
Okay, I will.
Hey, what's going on? You're only working half days these days?
No, I'm running over to the courthouse. The verdict came in. I want to see what's going on.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, see ya.
Bye. Listen, you can tell me about Tony before, from the look on your face, I can...
I gotta go somewhere. Cover for me, okay? Pam, is something wrong with Meg again?
I don't know. Maybe she's just bummed out about the trial. No.
Pam, I was just having a cup of coffee with Iva, and she said she saw Emily up here.
Yeah, she was here a little bit before, but I think she went to Fashions.
Okay, thanks. I'll catch up with her.
So how was the rest of your holiday?
Terrific. Yours?
It was great. Best Christmas I could ever remember. Why are you looking at me that way?
For someone who puts so much stock in honesty, you sure lie easily. Happy New Year.
Good old fashions. This place has been a part of my life for so long, I can't believe that I may not see this again.
Come on now, Barbara. Don't give up hope.
Lisa, the hoping and the waiting is all over.
Oh, Lisa's right. You can't give up hope. Okay? You ready?
Sure.
Let's go.
Oh, Holden, I am so glad that you're here. Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Listen, the jury's gonna be delivering its verdict about 4 o'clock. Could you maybe stay here with me until we hear something?
Sure, I'll stay right here. I must have just missed you earlier at the hospital.
What were you doing at the hospital?
I had to give Iva a check. She said she saw you there. So did Pam.
Well, I had a doctor's appointment with Dr. Michaels.
You were pretty restless last night.
What do you expect, Holden? I mean, the jury's still out and everything that's been going on.
When we get home tonight, let's not invite anybody over, all right?
Okay.
I want to be alone with you tonight.
Okay. Mother?
Hello, darling. And it's my new son-in-law.
Holden, Mother.
Holden. I wasn't invited to the wedding, so I never got a chance to properly welcome you into the family.
All right, Manuel. Well, I've wired the money. You should be getting it by tomorrow. Of course, it's my pleasure. Uh-huh. All right, I'll talk with you soon. Goodbye. Meg, I have incredible news for you.
What? What is it? What is it?
Montega has been liberated.
Well, that's great.
Meg, what's the matter with you?
Well, I have news, too. The verdict is in.
Well, aren't you going to say anything?
What is there to say?
You know, I have been hearing from everybody all day long, them talk about your testimony, and I keep coming back to the same thing, that you made a deal so that we wouldn't be prosecuted in exchange for that testimony.
Meg, the deal that I made in no way affected anything that I said on that witness stand.
I don't like Barbara Ryan any more than you do, but...
And what is that supposed to mean?
If you have the slightest doubt whether she was running to or from the Ruxton Hills house that night, you've got to come forward now. I don't know how you could live with yourself if you sent an innocent woman to prison. I don't know if I could.
Darling, we're praying for you. Do me a favor, would you? When the verdict comes in, just promise me that you'll take care of Paul.
Oh,
all right,
honey,
no,
don't
please.
Think that way.
Of course we will, Barbara.
You know we will, of course.
So what happened with the judge?
Well, the jury wanted to ask some questions about a lighter charge than second-degree murder.
I wonder what that means.
Well, there's no way of knowing now, Ed.
I just wanted to tell you again. Nobody could have fought harder or been more fair than you.
Thanks, son. I sure hope you're right.
Darling, I want to talk to Barbara,
all right? All right!
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
Defendant, please rise and face the jury. How do you find the defendant, Barbara Ryan?
Children's Clothes by Good Lad of Philadelphia. Special programming, As the World Turns, will be seen on most of these stations 1/2 hour earlier this Thursday. Join us tomorrow for the Emmy Award winner, As the World Turns.